it's 2 in the afternoon and you ain't high, go fuck yourself. Get out of my face.
I played freshman ball and we were playing Patterson East Side. That's Wait. Just a jungle of a school. Like, you got to be careful when you go in there. And we went there to play the Christmas tournament.
Wait, what kind of ball are we talking right now?
Basketball.
Oh, basketball.
And I hadn't taken a shit for like 10 days. I was backed up something. I took acid, something fucked my stomach up. I didn't tell nobody. In those days, I was really scared of doctors, and I wouldn't say shit to nobody. And on the way home, we got on the bus. And while we were waiting there, my stomach started hurting. And I said, Jesus Christ, I don't know if I'm going to shit myself or fart, but let me just take a chance.
Mm, good move.
And I blew this fart, Joe Rogan. That was so bad. Right? We were on a bus, and people started running. You know the school buses? People started running to the windows, right? To swing down the bus windows. But here's what gets better. I farted again. And the teachers were going, oh my God, he's changing flavors. But the worst, but the worst thing was the cheerleaders were crying. That's how bad it smelled. They were sitting in front of the bus going,
he's changing flavors.
One of the teachers yelled out, oh my God, he's changing flavors. That's how bad these farts were.
All right. Listen.
Stay black, because that's the most important.
Okay.
They have not found Osama bin Laden, and he's in New York right now. Somebody seen him last week at a hot dog stand. They know it.
Do you understand me? I mean, this was nonstop. Another night, Bonehead came home high on heroin. And he decided to make French fries. So he put the pot out. Remember in the 80s, they had those pots you could bring it home with the hot oil, and they would boil, and you could throw French fries. America went crazy over them. I forgot what they were. Crazy. Everybody was
French
making,
fry machines.
Everybody was making onion rings and shit. Well, he did heroin and knotted up.
Left
and
that thing running.
And the thing went on fire. We're all in the fucking house.
Oh, Jesus.
All right.
I
wake up to ba-boom and alarms and... Awesome, Kurt's waking me up, and we go out of the house, and the father's outside, and the grandmother, and the fire department crawls on top of the roof, Joe, and they're hitting the fucking roof to let the smoke out, and fire trucks are coming from the side, laying water, and they got the sirens. In the middle of all this, it's 8 in the morning, and we all look around and go, oh my God, Emil's still in the house, Bonehead was still in the house on fire. Bro, they turn the fire off, they go in, he's still with his feet up. With his hands crossed.
Just heroin out of his
watching
mind.
Watching TV like that happened.
He slept through the fire?
Oh my God, everything. When they woke him up, he goes, are my fries ready? This is how crazy this family was. Are my fries ready?
They're like, Bonehead,
we have 2 fucking battalions out there. We got half a 9/11 out there.
Oh my God.
And you're still fucking sleeping. Hold on, let me go get a wine glass.
Yeah.
Just give me the fucking glasses. I gotta wait. Just pour the fucking wine in there. What's the difference? Well, the wine glass, the aromatic. Listen, shut the fuck up before I smack you. Just give me the fucking wine.
Yeah.
He would always come down with wine glasses. It would piss me the fuck off to no end. And the girls would be impressed. Oh my God, shut the fuck up. Drink the wine. Just shut the fuck up. Drink the fucking wine, you know? Like, I'm one of those guys. I don't like no drama. And the people I remember one time going out to dinner with my friends. I'll never forget this. I still talk to them. The Holloways. Roger had just graduated high school. The craziest family I grew up with.
Yeah.
Dad was a bookie. Mom worked in the city on a ship, like for a shipping company. And it's his 18th. We just graduated high school. And he took us to a fancy restaurant. And I'll never forget, the guy comes over with the thing in front of him.
Yeah.
The Mr. Holloway says, can I get a bottle of wine? The guy comes over with the thing in front of him. And he, you know, takes the bottle. And he pours a little, and he tastes it first. I'll never forget, in high school, my friend looked, and he goes, da-da-da-da-da, just give me the fucking wine. The guy's face turned pale.
Really?
I just give me the wine. I don't want no show.
Yeah.
You don't have to taste it. You don't do nothing. Just take a fucking hike. Give me the wine. Like, we all froze at the table.
Oh.
Like, I grew up with people like that. Like, one time we were at a buffet, and some fat chick was eating ribs.
You gotta fucking go in New York, man.
Yeah, you gotta go.
People don't go like this in New York at a stop sign.
Yeah.
You know how they do here? Like, no, you go. Get the fuck, somebody fucking go already. Fucking moron, I gotta get to the weed store.
When Israelis come to the store,
You better be prepared. They fucking come heavy duty to the store. I've been up there a couple Tuesdays, and three of them have stuck up on me. We're from Israel. Where's the flying Jew? We want a party. Where's the stars of death? They're fucking nuts. And you gotta love them. You gotta love them. And they were comics. From listening to Rogan Experience, they started doing comedy. I guess Israel's got a big comedy scene there now.
It's just starting now.
It's just starting, and they fucking want to be rough comics. Wow. So the one kid's like, I'm trying to do fucking Hitler jokes, and they're, and they're throwing me out of all these places. I'm fucking howling. I'm howling. People are like, what is he talking about? He's like, I'm doing fucking these dirty Hitler jokes, and then Israeli people throwing me out of restaurants and shit. So he goes, I'm coming to America to do Hitler jokes.
I'm coming to
nothing but heart. Nothing but heart, these motherfuckers. I'm sitting there going, oh no. Where's the flying Jew? We want to meet him.
I'm coming to America to do Hitler jokes.
Oh my God, he was pissed, this kid. He was serious. He's like, dog, my comedy's a little rough, man. He goes, I'm up there doing fucking Nazi jokes and shit. They throw me out of the comedy.
The energy concept of it. I am suffering so much inside. And I have so much anxiety inside. I got two options.
You unleash it.
I could either go up there and go, or do my comedy.
Yeah.
So how does my comedy come out? Like if I'm yelling, I take that mic, wow, wow, and I got it. Fucking, I'm going.
Sock him.
There's
right
no
the
measuring
mouth.
With
no,
me.
No, you sock him right in the mouth.
You know. Oh, he's measuring. They love it when the audience boos. You're that's
Anthony
when you know
Rumble
you're doing
Johnson.
Your job.
No,
I'm at the Comedy Store. I'm following 8 beasts, and I got 3 beasts behind me. I told him the other day, I don't go to the Comedy Store to be the best comic. I go to the Comedy Store to be remembered.
There's been, you know, a lot of people that are moving towards minimalist houses, really small houses.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the idea is that, like, really, why do we have to have this giant fucking footprint of house that we live in, you know? And
because you're getting paid, bitch. If I want to live in a fucking cell, I'll live in a fucking cell like a monkey. I'm going to live with a fold-up bed like I'm James Bond. Like, if you're getting paid, you live in a fucking house. I'm going to live in a micro fucking house with a little kitchen to cook like I got a black guy banging me in the fucking ass. I don't need that. A micro house. What are you fucking people talking about? I just snapped out of it, dog. You can't take me into those deep waters like this. Fucking, the Eureka fucking killed the brother right now. The fuck are these people with micro houses in the fucking desert? You play it out to the world ends like a doctor.
I want to live in one of those, the Airstream ones.
Brian's down, Joey's not. I think we have a real clear line
fuck
of sand
that
here, people.
Shit.